Welcome back to Terraria. This is Jerry. And today we're going to continue from the last place we left off. I'm still playing the audio through the external speaker, so you might be able to hear that coming in through the mic. I'll just do it for a little while and then I'll switch back to the headset. But yeah, if there's any feedback or anything, I turn the speakers down. There we go. So today I want to prepare for the final stuff. Basically, let's do this. Oh my gosh, it's so funny. What game am I playing? Okay. So, let's go. Let's put one of these chests up here. Just so we can stick stuff into it. There we go. And then, where is that stuff that I bought? Oh, is that it? There it is. Purification button. I'm going to stick that here, and I guess if I do that, then I'm never going to find those, again because of that bottom bar. Something that'd be nice for the Android version would be if we could somehow, if there's some way, a way to hide that bottom bar. I'm not really sure where it comes from, but it could be coming from the controller part of the shield, but I'm not really sure. I don't think Secret Mana had anything like that. Okay, perfect. So I'm going to... I've got my pick and everything. Oh, God. Alright, let's go over here. So basically, from what I hear, is that those... Oh, this whole thing's still burning. I'm so glad there's not permanent negative effects of running through something like that, like, you know, the armor losing durability or something, where you have to eventually replace it. So yeah, I'm going to basically burn a lot of this stuff out. Just to make it a little bit easier to access it. Cut through the bottom part of the beach. So I know where those pod things are. Swatting brilliant torches. I didn't bring torches, cool. Well, where we're going, we don't need torches, right? Yeah, where I'm going, I need torches. What am I saying? So yeah, if I destroy these, from what I hear, it increases the probability of getting some really good, armor. Good, I'm just kicking myself. I can't believe I forgot the, torches of all things. So anyways, in order to maximize on that, I need to go through layer by layer and make sure that I get every single layer. there down, and I'd need to go back. Seems to be the easiest way to do it. World 1. Another thing I discovered, well, I didn't really discover it, but I just came to my attention. Does that work? Not really. That's all. I believe that. Somewhere else around here. Is that, well, if I'm saving my character on the cloud, how am I going to be able to... Here, I didn't need an invisibility. How am I going to be able to access it when I'm not connected to the internet? Which is primarily what I'm going to be... Well, I'll take one of those eyes. Go over there. Which is primarily what I'm planning on... Yeah, I plan to play this, like, on, you know, once... day every like 30 minutes or something. And it won't be connected with home, it won't be at an internet site, that's for sure. It'll be on completely mobile. Which is something I've mentioned about my setup, but it's something that this setup allows is complete offline and mobile. Come on, I know. Mobile let's play. So you can, and with an added added US, what am I saying? It's an added, this one, right? USB charger, or battery, USB battery. Portable USB battery pack. I think they have them. I've got one. Yeah, I've got one. I've got a 7800 millihertz or something. So adding that will make it, you know, completely power mobile as well. If that makes any sense. Basically, I'm looking for mobility. Yeah, remember I can carve through this stuff as well. So I got that. So the plan is that I need to empty that water too. I'm gonna go in there with that hammer when I get it and destroy all the stuff. Might be able to do it right now actually. Oh, those things are relentless. That's the one thing I'm not quite happy about games like this, is that spawning. You know, some like Minecraft uses torches to stop spawning areas, but I'm really looking forward to, you know, Minecraft did it with animals, where if you were to you know, exhaust an area of the wildlife, then they wouldn't come back. But I'd like to see something similar to that with monsters. And this is an idea that I kind of thought up. I may have mentioned it or something. Basically, the ability to have, like, invisible... Like, Minecraft is about blocks. And now they have command blocks. Well, why can't they have an invisible... moving invisible block that's, you know, kind of like those moving pistons or whatever those things are called. Basically a block that's intelligent. And just put them all over the place and have them move around invisibly, and you know, you can't interact with them or anything. But they are physical within the dimensions of the Earth. And only monsters can spawn from that block. You know, that block is what would spawn the monsters. And that way, you know, you could, like, wall this off. It would make more sense to you could wall this off. You could wall this off. And this off. Somehow you can destroy that block. So, I don't know, like, you know, maybe it can't spawn more than, like, 10 monsters in a certain area or something before it goes to another area. Or maybe it has to move around, or, you know, eventually it's like, you know, a fish will stop, I don't know if it's a myth or something, but it'll eventually stop being able to live or something. I don't know. Just something like that. Basically just a way where you can shut the monsters off through something that's more logical than just, you know, torching it up. Because, I mean, there's nothing wrong with, you know, pitch black areas. I mean, unless you're one of those people that believes, you know, that monsters hide in pitch black areas all the time. But if you can't access an area, then, I don't know. I'm sure they have a reason behind it, like a, some kind of, like a superstitious, just something to say, well, they're around because we think they're around or something like that. I don't know. Something I was thinking about. like I'm really not conserving that powder. I could just use twice in one go. So basically, my understanding is when hard mode, when you eventually reach hard mode, right? I want to destroy those receptacles. You know, the altars. Stuff over there, maybe. You found me. office area. I'm just wondering how big this area is. Here we go. That's it, so that's the end. I don't think there's anything up there. Guess what I'll do is I'll just drill down. I get the feeling that like that's the only area where I'm gonna actually find those things. I think that's pretty good. I mean, there's a thermal. Gotta explore that pyramid. I get the feeling that I'm not going to find anything else. That was pretty much the top, right? Yeah, that's the top. That's the meteor. What did I get on that? Okay, run right in. Torch on. So I don't see, like, anything down there either. Like, I'm not really looking into mapping everything, I just want to get, like, a general idea. Like, anything that's massive. Because I think it'll, I think it'll, be pretty notable when I reach an area with altars. But if I miss one, or if I miss a group, then I'm not gonna, you know, whimper over it. I don't know what I was gonna say. Dread over it, maybe. What's a good word for that? Somebody's got to be an English major in here. Even knowing the basic English. water. Thank you. something million. I'll take a break right now, and I'll be back in a little bit.